that we had what we wanted to going on. I think that the more and more plays that I'm getting in there, Coach Cortez is getting more and more comfortable with me, and I think that he's allowing us to take those shots down the field, and he was putting us in situations to be successful in the second half. I mean, it called for us to have to throw because we were behind. So our team came up on our offense, did what we had to do to be able to execute, to be able to go down the field and score.
Was it slower for you this week than last week?
I think it was the same. I mean, I think that we've done a good job of preparing both weeks. I think that we just went out and we executed at a higher level this week as an offense. You have to give credit to Hamilton last week. They came out and they forced us into certain situations, but we were able to battle back today and get the win.
Did you feel like you might get the hook at halftime?
No, not at all. I mean, I felt like we were going in a situation to where we could keep moving the ball, we could keep putting ourselves in positions to be successful, and we were just looking forward to the second half because we knew we wanted to play better.
What about with Weston Dresser? Do you kind of need to develop that sort of relationship with him to pull things out a little bit?
No, I think that me and Wes have a good relationship. I think that me and the receivers were on the same page with a lot of stuff. I mean, you can always go back and you can pick things out that you want to get better at, obviously. I mean, we're nowhere near where we want to be at the end of the year, but this is a good stepping stone for us as an offense to keep moving forward, to keep growing, to keep trying to get better so that we can get better and better each week.
Do you think you proved something to the people in the Rider Nation? We kept asking questions about what Tino can do, and to lead them in a comeback win. Does this sort of answer some of the questions you've had about you?
Did you miss a BC game? No. I mean,
as a starter, okay.
No. I mean, I think that we just want to go out and we want to keep playing better and better each week. We want to keep on growing. And obviously, whenever you lose someone like Darian, I mean, that's a huge blow. I mean, here's a guy that's 9 years in the league, won a Grey Cup, and has been a star in this league. And we just had to refocus in, understand what Darian brings to the table, what I bring to the table, so that we can put our offense in the best situation to be successful.
You do a lot of core work throughout the offseason. You try and work on your balance and, you know, your core strength to be able to absorb hits like that and keep moving. So, also just say lucky. Lucky. Sometimes you get lucky.
Not to take anything away from your offensive performance, but a couple missed field goals, a couple of bad snaps. What were the issues on those two misses?
We just got to have better rhythm between snapper, holder, kicker. I felt like we were a little off today. It surprised me because I thought we had a great week of practice throughout the week. So we'll check out the film, and you know, us three, we'll get together and work on that a little more this week and make sure that's corrected.
Was it just safe to say you needed a couple of weeks to sort of learn Tino and vice versa as well? Because it sort of seems now that you're on the same page.
Yeah, maybe. I think Tino was very comfortable today. He made some great throws. You know, I wish we would have made some more plays for him because he could have had a much bigger day than he did. But we found a way to win, and that's what matters most.
When the East beats the West 3-4, how big is it to be the only West team to win this week when it's so tight in the West?
It's huge. But as a team, you know, we just got to stay focused on what we can control. We can't control the other games that are going on throughout the rest of the week. We can control our game and do what we can to go 1-0 every week from here on out. So you can't really get too caught up in what's happening with other teams.
It's disappointing. I mean, we fought our butts off all game, and yeah, it's difficult.
You go into third place all time with Ron Lancaster with your touchdown passes, but I assume that's a little
of anything too right now. Yeah, I mean, right now it's all about the present and getting it done. I mean, we had a chance to pull off a big win here, and you know, we can't have those crazy things happen in the end. Of course, you know, I wish I would have taken tucking it and ran on that first overtime, but sometimes you're damned if you do, damned if you don't. And, you know, kudos to them for doing a good job.
Wait for getting me a sack, man.
Yeah, we had some performances today, that's for sure. Like that one, I think that one catch and touchdown by Weston when he just spun six times, I think that got us going. And, you know, T. George is a beast all day. I hope he gets his just due, you know, because he's the best D tackle in the league, and I hope people start to recognize that.
You've been a part of a game like this, back and forth, and a crazy finish.
I've been part of some crazy ones. I mean, one time we played Montreal in Toronto and we kicked it in, kicked it back out and all that. But then not like this, like a, you know, we score, then they don't. I don't know, crazy. I jumped outside the end of the game. I was like sweating like a man. I hope it's on me. So, yeah, but then we got the block at the end. That was huge. So, super crazy game, man. If you had to describe the CFL to somebody, you had to show them a game to describe what it's all about. You just show the last 10 minutes of this game, right? So, hope it's good for the fans, but you know, we'll take it. We got some work to do.
Well,
was it like on the sideline before Tino made the game-tying drive?
Man, you know, we stick together here. We always believe, you know, somehow, some way, the last year and a half, or last, you know, that I've been here, you know, we just somehow find a way to win. You know, coaches call the right plays, and, you know, hopefully we take what we're doing at the end of the game and carry it over next week and forget about the first half and, you know, just continue to do the things that worked in the second half.
Thank you.